So today we are very fortunate that we are having His Grace Ram Kitari Prabhu to enlighten us on Chaitanya Charitamrita. So Prabhuji, are you present on the call?
Mataji, he hasn't joined yet. So wait like for a few minutes.
Hare Krishna Mataji, Dhanna Pranam, all glories to Srila Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. This is Anjana Gopika Devdasi.
Hare Krishna, Anjana Gopika Mataji. So today's speaker is His Grace Ram Gadari Prabhu. So thank you so much Prabhuji for giving your valuable association. Now you can take over the class. Thank you Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. So we are reading from Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela Chapter 20. This is a very interesting chapter where Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is instructing Sanatana Goswami on the science of Krishna consciousness. And this knowledge that Mahaprabhu is giving is very much relevant and important for all of us to understand. So we are reading from text number 342. Krishna Varnam Tvisha Krishnam Sango Pangastra Parsadam Yajnai Sankirtanair Praya Yajan.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Mataji, I think Prabhuji has dropped. Hare
Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hi, Bol. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, Prabhuji. Now we can hear you.
Sorry. Okay, I don't know what happened. So I'll read the translation. In the age of Kali, intelligent persons perform congregational chanting to worship the incarnation of Godhead, who constantly sings the name of Krishna. Although his complexion is not blackish, he is Krishna himself. He is accompanied by his associates, servants, weapons, and confidential companions. Purport. This is a quotation from Srimad Bhagavatam 11.5.32. See also Adi Leela, Chapter 3, Text number 52. We will discuss this particular verse and churn this further detail to discuss about the glories of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namaom Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदी गौर भक्त वृंदा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्णावर्णं तुविषा कृष्णं साङ्गोपाङ्गस्त्रपार्षदं यज्ञैर्सङ्कीर्तनैः प्रायैः यजन्ति हि सुमेधसाम् इन् द एज् आफ् कलि इण्टेलिजेण्ट् पर्सन् पर्फार्म् काङ्ग्रिगेशनल् चाण्टिङ्ग् टु वर्शिप् द इन्कार्नेशन् आफ् गाड् हू कान्स्टेण्ट्लि सिङ्ग्स् द नेम् आफ् कृष्ण आल्दो हिस् काम्प्लेक्षन् इस् नाट् ब्लाकिश् हि इस् कृष्ण हिम्सेल्फ़् He is accompanied by his associates, servants, weapons, and confidential companions. So, this is a very famous verse. Srila Prabhupada is referring this verse in more than one place. And he explained about the glories of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's incarnation, and as a part of Mahaprabhu's manifested Leela, Mahaprabhu performed many feats, and this particular shloka explains in totality about Mahaprabhu's manifestation, Mahaprabhu's avatar. It is very interesting to note that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he himself is speaking about this verse to Sanatana Goswami without referring to whom he is addressing. So Mahaprabhu's incarnation is a secret incarnation. Not everybody can understand, not everybody can appreciate, not everybody will be able to participate in the Leela of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And this being a confidential Leela, Mahaprabhu revealed himself only to some specific set of people. And as a part of this, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu revealed confidentially to Ramanujacharya, to Vallabhacharya, to various other personalities. But he made sure that his glories are never openly shared during his manifested time. And Srila Prabhupada, when explaining about this particular verse in Adi Leela, he writes that Srila Jiva Goswami explains that Krishna Varnam means Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Krishna Varna and Krishna Chaitanya are equivalent. The name Krishna appears with both Lord Krishna and Lord Chaitanya Krishna. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but he always engages in describing Krishna and thus enjoys transcendental bliss by chanting and remembering his name and form. Lord Krishna himself appears as Lord Chaitanya to preach the highest gospel. And in that explaining, he mentions in the last paragraph, Srila Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, a famous disciple of Lord Chaitanya, said, "The principle of transcendental devotional service having been lost, Sri Krishna Chaitanya appeared in order to deliver again the process of devotion." So we need to be very grateful to Srila Prabhupada Because this one incarnation of the Supreme Lord, he has come up with so much of mercy. In one shot, he is trying to give a fast access to that position which otherwise is not made available by any other incarnation. So, Srila Prabhupada, one of the important contributions he gave to all of us is giving us Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It so happened that in Advaita Acharya's birthplace, Shantipur, there used to be a pujari who narrated an episode to one of the disciples of Srila Prabhupada. Her name is Moola Prakriti Mataji. So this episode that I'm going to share was personally shared by that pujari in Advaita Acharya's house. He said, there used to be a sadhu who used to regularly visit Advaita Acharya's birthplace, and this sadhu used to regularly sit there during the weekends, and he used to come in his dhoti kurta, white dhoti and kurta, sit there, and he used to regularly chant, and he never used to speak to anyone, and he used to leave after finishing his chanting. And there were some weeks where he used to come and sometimes used to cry and weep. This went on since this person does not used to speak to anyone. So he was a puzzle to the pujari. And in between, this sadhu did not visit. And after several months, sadhu in a saffron cloth came in sannyasi vesha. And he looked more or less like the person who used to come before and chant. So one day, it so happened that Srila Prabhupada, pujari in the Shantipur, Advaita Acharya Bhavan, he went and spoke to this sadhu and said that, I've been seeing you for so many years. Every time you come here, you cry, you chant, you don't speak to anyone, and you just leave. Who are you? Why are you crying? And today, you seem to be very much in anxiety. May I know the reason for that? So this sadhu said, I am Abhay Charanaravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami, and I am disciple of Om Vishnupad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. My Guru Maharaj entrusted upon me with a vision which is seemingly impossible by my capacity, but just that I have faith in the words of my spiritual master that I wish to do something for him. And to fulfill his promise, I am boarding Jaladuta to go to USA to spread the glories of the holy name. So please bestow your blessings upon me. I don't have any friends. My health is not so good. And I don't have money. And I'm not sure how I'm going to fulfill the mission. But all I know is, the words of the spiritual master carry the potency. So saying this, Srila Prabhupada, who was regularly visiting Advaitacharya's place, since he was a grihastha, enduring for fulfilling the orders of his spiritual master, proceeded for going to overseas. So what is explained in this shloka, that the congregational chanting to worship the incarnation of Godhead, which was inaugurated by the Supreme Lord, incidentally, who himself is speaking about it without revealing his identity, his mission was carried forward by various personalities, including Srila Prabhupada. This particular shloka, Krishnadas Kaviraja Goswami is speaking in Adi Leela in the context of explaining about Mahaprabhu's external reasons for the appearance. Mahaprabhu appeared for various reasons, external as well as internal, but Krishnadas Kaviraja Goswami has compiled them as three external reasons and three internal and confidential reasons. And these three reasons that Mahaprabhu cried or Mahaprabhu appeared are very much relevant for each and every one of us. Otherwise, we will not be able to sit and talk Srimad Bhagavatam. So as a part of today's discussion, to chant this verse, we are going to discuss about six different sets of points, or six set of realizations through which we will churn this. Once Narada Muni became concerned as he was seeing Kali Yuga approaching. He became worried and went to Dwaraka. Narada Muni knew what is the evil effects of Kali Yuga, and he knew Kali Yuga is full of dosha, and he knew Kali Yuga is age of hypocrisy and quarrel. So being a very kind-hearted sadhu, he went and approached Krishna in Dwaraka. In Dwaraka, Krishna was at Satyabhama's house and he was about to leave to Rukmini's house. And over in Rukmini's house, grand celebrations were planned because they were planning to receive Krishna over there. So when Krishna reached Rukmini's house, a grand welcome was given to Krishna, and so detailed arrangements were made to serve the Supreme Lord. But as soon as Krishna entered the house, even though everybody were happy, even though everybody were jubilant, even though everybody were satisfied that Krishna finally arrived, Rukmini started to cry. Krishna couldn't understand why Rukmini is crying. Krishna said that just now I came, I thought by my visit you will be happy. But you are crying. So Rukmini said to Krishna that only Radharani know my predicament. The reason for my crying, only Radharani can understand, because she knew what it means to be you leaving a person alone and walking away. Even though you just came in, you will not going to stay here for long, you will leave. So the moment I think about you leaving us, I am not able to tolerate. So now Krishna doesn't know what to do, because he was on a spot. Narada Muni arrived at that time, exactly. So Krishna said, thank God, my dear Narada Muni, you just came and saved my embarrassment. So Krishna thought within himself, because Krishna doesn't want to answer this situation of Rukmini, because he knew he is going to leave. So when Narada Muni came, Rukmini and Krishna both welcomed Narada Muni and served Narada Muni. And what happened was, Narada Muni was also worried. So he said, now I thought you are my solace to save from Rukmini's crying. Now you are putting me in a spot. What will I do now? So Krishna asked Narada Muni, Narada Muni, why are you worried? And this time Krishna is in both embarrassment as well as concerned, because both Rukmini and Narada Muni were in the same mood. And finally Narada Muni said, my dear Lord, I am so much worried that the age of quarrel and hypocrisy is approaching, and the people in Kali Yuga will not have any other option to get your pure love with so much of quarrelsome. And I'm just worried about them. So that's when Krishna gave an assurance that he will come as Gauranga. Now we will come back to earthly planets. So Advaitacharya felt sorry for the condition of the world, because even after Lord Krishna's appearance, no one had interest in devotional service to Krishna. This forgetfulness was so much overwhelming that Advaitacharya wanted the Lord himself to come again and deliver. So he started offering tulsi leaves and Ganges water, and he constantly cried and wept for the Lord to appear. So hence our first realization is that Mahaprabhu appeared in our heart, in our life, and in Kali Yuga because of cries of his dear devotees. Srila Prabhupada cried in Advaitacharya Samadhi for delivering the mlechas and yavanas and chandalas and degraded men. Advaitacharya cried and begged for mercy and invited the Lord to appear. Narada Muni cried for all of us to get delivered. And because of these cries, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is appearing in Kali Yuga. So these three cries brought Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance. And this Mahaprabhu who appeared, for him to appear within our heart, we also need to cry. And Krishna Vrindavan Das Thakura is explaining this very nicely. He says, Bhakti Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Bhakti Yoga Dana, Bhakti E Krishna Nama, Smarana or Krandana. Bhakti E Krishna Nama, Smarana, Krandana. So according to Vrindavan Das Thakur, devotional life means Krishna Nama Smarana, meditating on the holy name of the Lord, and Krandana, crying. So our first realization is, Mahaprabhu's appearance for spreading the congregational chanting in the complexion that is not that of Krishna, along with his associate servants, weapons and confidential companions, was made possible because of the compassionate mood of devotees who cried for his appearance, and their cry was not for themselves because they already had access to Krishna directly. They cried for all of us. If they cried for us, what to speak of we needing to do for our own devotional journey? Hence our first realization is, we need to learn to cry. And what is this cry all about? Cry as an acronym is, we need to consciously and repentantly yearn for Mahaprabhu's mercy. Doyal nitai chaitanya bole nachraya marmon. So with this mood of crying, Doyal nitai chaitanya bole, they will come and dance. This is exactly what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is singing in his song Boro Shukir Kabur Gai. He says, Ek bar dekhle chakshe jal, ek bar dekhle chakshe jal. Gaur bole nitai den sakala sambal. Ek bar dekhle chakshe jal. If Nityananda Prabhu see once tears welling in the eyes of a person who is chanting the holy name of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, then Gaura bole nitai den sakala sambal. So this beautiful lords, Gauranga Nityananda, appeared, and their appearance is centered around how much we are consciously and repentantly yearn for them. And hence, our first realization is about crying for Krishna. Gaur Govinda Maharaj said that ISKCON is a crying school where we learn to cry for Krishna's mercy. This is our first realization. The second realization is this wonderful Gauranga Mahaprabhu's incarnation is relevant for whom? Who is going to come and give his blessings? Why did he choose Kali Yuga? What is the qualification for receiving Mahaprabhu's mercy? Crying is what we need to do, that which Mahaprabhu can be attracted. But it is also explained, the reason Mahaprabhu chose to come in Kali Yuga is his target is to give his blessings for the disqualified men and women, the disqualified soul. A soul who can't take advantage of every possible opportunity, he kept on failing by all the endeavors, is a qualified candidate to receive Mahaprabhu's mercy. So the second realization is to receive Mahaprabhu's blessings. The candidate not only need to cry, he should also realize that I am disqualified for doing anything else. Because by our design, we are not qualified to receive the benediction. Our greatest qualification is our disqualification. And this was time and again established in Chaitanya Charitamrita and different discussions Srila Prabhupada had. In Jagai and Madai episode, when Mahaprabhu wanted to finish off Madai, who made Nityananda Prabhu bleed, Nityananda Prabhu is begging and said that please understand, if you want to chop off anybody's head, nobody will remain in this Kali Yuga because everybody is as disqualified as Madai. Hence, my dear Lord, please bestow your benedictions upon them and transform their consciousness. In the same song, Boro Shukar Kabor Gai, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is singing, Dasturi lo ibo ami purnaha bekam. He says, everybody please come to Nam Hatta and chant the holy name of the Lord. And when you do that, and when I'm engaged in such a service, Dasturi lo ibo ami, Nityananda Prabhu will give my due commission. And hence, I am requesting all of you, please come and take advantage of Nitai's mercy. So the second realization is, Gauranga Mahaprabhu as well as Nityananda Prabhu, their incarnation is especially to bestow their benediction upon the disqualified people. So the mood in which we need to approach is confirmed, that we don't only cry, we don't only repent, we are not only yearning, we also understand we don't have any qualification and we are just beggars for the mercy. The third realization to explain about this particular shloka in detail is about three external reasons of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance. The three reasons of Mahaprabhu's appearances are: distribute the very rare mood of love of Godhead, fulfill his promise in Bhagavad Gita of yada yada hi dharmasya, wherever and whenever the dharma is going to, you know, pop out, I will appear to destroy the evil effects. And third is to respond to the cries of Advaita Acharya, Narada Muni and great Vaishnavas who were looking for our welfare. So the third realization hence is to understand and appreciate Mahaprabhu's appearance is with a purpose. And it is not just any other casual entertainment the Lord has taken appearance for his own rasa. So his appearance is pretty much to bestow us the rarest of the opportunity which otherwise as disqualified has filtered out souls from all the other processes and all the other ages, we won't have a chance. The fourth realization is about three confidential reasons of his appearance. The three confidential reasons for his appearance are to relish the position of Srimati Radharani, to understand the transcendental mellow of himself, and to enjoy the bliss tasted by Srimati Radharani. To relish the position, what is Srimati Radharani's position? Sometimes Krishna used to get bewildered. It is said that Krishna is called Madana Mohan and Radharani is called Madana Mohana Mohini. Because Krishna is Rasaraj, he also wants to enjoy the rasa of him being Srimati Radharani, which whilst him being Krishna, he couldn't do it. So that is why Krishna is coming as Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna Nahe Anya. So the fourth point, reflection or realization or the knowledge that I would like to share is about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's three confidential reasons for his appearance. I'm sure you all might be knowing about it, but it is extremely important to reiterate them because in Kali Yuga, they are Manda Sumanda Matayo, Manda Bhagya Upadrataha. We are short-lived, lazy, misguided, unfortunate, and disturbed. The fifth realization, or the fifth point that I want to share as a part of this verse, is about three unique aspects of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's avatar. We have time and again spoken about this, but in this context, it becomes all the more relevant. Mahaprabhu possesses those qualities that no other incarnation possess. And it is explained, those three unique aspects of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu alone is Adbhuta Karunya, Adbhuta Vadanya, and Adbhuta Audarya. He is amazingly merciful, he is amazingly magnanimous, and he is amazingly munificent. The reason he is amazingly, the word mercy is bringing someone relief from something unpleasant, which means I am trying to be helping somebody to bring them out of a big danger. So Mahaprabhu, by his amazing mercy, he is delivering us, giving us relief from the cycle of birth and death, which we have been going through since time immemorial. And by that mercy, we could become Mahatma from a stage of Naradama. He is called amazingly munificent. Adbhuta Audarya is that this mercy is not only limited, this mercy is unlimited. It is not that the mercy is given with some special, you know, measurement. This mercy is given so much so that there is no shortage or there is no restriction. In the invocation verse, in Adi Leela. It's a very beautiful verse. Anarpita charim chirat karuna yavartina kalau. He says, anarpita, this mercy that Mahaprabhu is going to give, he's never been given before by anybody. This causeless mercy, no incarnation has ever offered before. And he is taking us to a position which otherwise we can't imagine. So hence, munificent. With great generosity, the Lord is giving this mercy. And Adbhuta Vadanya, it is not only he is giving profusely, it is not only that he is, you know, getting rid of us from a danger, he is also giving this to everybody. Even if he is a rival, even if he is an enemy. Magnanimous means without seeing a qualification. We must have been whatever we have been. So this combination had never happened in the past. And hence, Vrindavan Das Thakur is singing. Ajanulambita bhujau kanakavadato sankirtanaika pitarau kamalayataksho vishvambarau dvijabarau Yugadharma Palau Vande Jagat Priyakaro Karuna Avataro. Vrindavan Das Thakur is glorifying that Ajanu Lambita Bhujau, their hands are too long to extend to a, you know, it extends to their knees. Kanakava Dhatav, their bodily beauty is golden in complexion. Sankirtanaika Pitarav, they are fathers of Sankirtan movement. They mean Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu. Kamalaya Takshav, their eyes are lotus-eyed. Vishwambarav, they are Vishwambar, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Dvijabarav, so these Brahmana, these wonderful personalities, they have come to deliver us, deliver the people of this material world. Yuga Dharma Palav, to uphold the Yuga Dharma. Vande Jagat Priyakarav, I offer my benedictions, I offer my obeisances to such personality like Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu. Karunavatarav, they are merciful incarnation. So hence our fifth realization is about the uniqueness of Mahaprabhu's mercy. And the last realization is that to such an incarnation we should have some prayers. And these prayers, we offer, these prayers are, what we are going to share is not just limited to these prayers. But these prayers, we need to offer to Mahaprabhu with a firm conviction in the heart. And each of this prayer, we are going to share three sets of prayers. Each of these prayers, by offering to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we become eligible candidate amongst the disqualified to get the mercy of Mahaprabhu. Even amongst the disqualified people in this Kali Yuga, we still will get privilege when we offer these three prayers. The prayer number one. Mahaprabhu is called Patita Pavan, but Mahaprabhu does not deliver a particular Patita who harms his devotees. So hence our prayer is to get the mercy of, to get the magnanimity of, to get the munificency of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu fully upon us, we need to pray and be conscious not to hurt, harm, offend Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's followers and his devotees. So we sincerely make an attempt and pray that, my dear Lord, please help me. This is a generic prayer which we do every time in every context. But when we glorify about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu so much so, that such a merciful personality will also be hostile, will also turn around if we don't respect and offer obeisances to his devotees. We have shared a story of Gopala Chappal in the past. Gopala Chappal offended Srivas Thakur and eventually got affected with leprosy to an extent that he got so acute that he went to Mahaprabhu for help, and Mahaprabhu did not give his mercy. He said, unless Srivas Thakur gives his mercy upon you, I can't help you. So, the same point Vrindavan Das Thakur is writing in Chaitanya Bhagavat. He says that a person who is not criticizing a Vaishnava and who is constantly chanting the holy name of the Lord, Satya Muhitare Udhari Lohele Anindaka Hoije Sakrit Krishna Bhaje Satya Satya Muhitare Udhari Lohele. He says, Anindaka Hoije. A person who is not criticizing and who is not offending a Vaishnava and then chanting the holy name of the Lord. So chanting the holy name of the Lord has a rider, that when we chant, we should also be equally conscious not to criticize a Vaishnava. So Mahaprabhu is saying, Vrindavan Das Thakur is quoting that. What he is saying? Anindaka hoije sakrit krishna bhaje satya satya muhitare udhari lohele. I promise, two times Mahaprabhu is saying, I deliver that person who does not criticize and who chants the holy name of the Lord. So hence our first prayer to such a wonderful incarnation is about helping us to be consciously avoiding Vaishnava aparadha. The second prayer that we offer to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, or Sankalpa we take towards Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is we commit and convince ourselves that we will preach to ourselves about the holy name, chant our rounds sincerely and attentively. This is a gift that we give to ourselves to win the mercy of Adbhuta Karunya. This is a very obvious, important statement, but still it is being stated because high-level statistics says that devotees are so compassionate on somebody else and helping and delivering them that they forgot to chant their own rounds. That is the state of our Krishna consciousness today. So, being in leadership responsibility, we happen to counsel a lot of devotees. So one obvious thing that we see is, after a certain point in time, we as devotees develop familiarity, complacency towards chanting, towards deities, and towards Vaishnavas, and towards holy scriptures, that we take them for granted. Hence, our second prayer to Mahaprabhu will be, my dear Lord, please help us in not getting complacent and be stern in our sadhana. Once Srila Prabhupada was sitting in his room behind the desk. He was chanting on his beads. And after finishing his 16th round, he had pounced on the table and said, now I can do any damn thing in this world. His Holiness Hanumat Preshek Maharaj once told this to me, referring to Srila Prabhupada. He said, Srila Prabhupada has personally said that if anyone who finishes their 16 rounds of Hare Krishna Mahamantra on their beads every day, they will be able to handle any problem, or no problem can shake them up in their life. I'm paraphrasing them. But the point is, in this material world, we will be posed with a lot of challenges, and this chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra can actually deliver us from those challenges. Hence, to this merciful, munificent incarnation, we pray that I will not only not criticize devotees, but I will also regularly chant and follow the four regulative principles. Please note that whenever we are bestowed with a service opportunity, the service opportunity that we get, because as we discussed in one of the earlier classes, services are empowered upon us. We are empowered to do service. Services cannot be demanded. Services have to be given to us by a Vaishnava. So we are empowered. And this empowerment and the service provided to us is nothing but acknowledgement of the Supreme Lord for the chanting that we did. So if all of us get service opportunity, we need to very clearly remember that Krishna heard our prayer, Krishna heard our chanting, and He is reciprocating. And if a Vaishnava visits your house, if a Vaishnava come and takes interest in your personal life, devotional life, then we need to remember that we are getting promoted in our devotional journey, and that Vaishnava is nobody other than Krishna's messenger to deliver your promotional message. So getting a service opportunity is Krishna's acknowledgement about our chanting, and getting a Vaishnava in our life means we are getting promoted in our spiritual journey. And what to speak of Vaishnava living with us, and we get an opportunity to live with Vaishnava in our own family. It's a great, glorious blessing, because Vaishnavas are the mouthpiece of the Supreme Lord. So please don't undermine a Vaishnava in your life. May them be your family members, your neighbors, your friends, and your, you know, colleagues. So the second realization hence is that we will, our second prayer is to somehow or other, we offer our prayer and convince ourselves that yes, I am committing, and I will ensure that this service of chanting, I will do it to deliver myself so that I can be prepared to deliver others. And the third prayer is about this mercy that we received to help Mahaprabhu in his mission. I'll spread the holy name and be part of the vision. And this realization or this prayer has got a caveat that I'll be part of Mahaprabhu's vision as a solution but not as a problem. Most of us are in his vision, most of us are in his mission, most of us are in his preaching movement, but sometimes we ourselves are the problem. We ourselves have, you know, thrown challenges. We ourselves are the, you know, trouble. But the prayer should be that, my dear Mahaprabhu, please make us useful enough that we are not part of the problem, but we are part of the solution. Srila Prabhupada, when he established ISKCON, when he spread the preaching movement, he knew very categorically that even though this movement is delivering so many wonderful, glorious people around the world, Srila Prabhupada also made a statement that Maya is also within the movement. This is a very powerful statement that Srila Prabhupada made, because he knew that some jokers like us, like me, may try to not take advantage of them and still beat around the bush. Hence, we need to take responsibility first for us, then with that in mind, go and help others to take up this Krishna consciousness process, especially chanting the holy name of the Lord. So this particular shloka helps us in remembering the reason why we are all reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, why we are all practicing Krishna consciousness. And the most secret information is Mahaprabhu is a Gupta incarnation. It's a secret incarnation, because here he is not even telling to Sanatana Goswami publicly, even though Sanatana Goswami knew Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. He is very subtly, consciously avoiding. So he is saying that an avatar, incarnation, will come and perform Sankirtan and deliver us. So we all are very fortunate to come in contact with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Sankirtan movement by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada and our Vaishnavas association, that we need to cherish them and take this forward in a very organized and committed manner. So before we conclude, I'd like to summarize our 6 points that we learned through this verse. Number 1, we narrated the story of Narada Muni visiting Dwaraka, Advaita Acharya's compassion for the people in Kali Yuga and crying to get Mahaprabhu appeared. Srila Prabhupada's endeavor to spread Mahaprabhu's message to the whole world. Hence, the cries of so many Vaishnavas brought Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance, about whom Mahaprabhu himself is talking in this verse. And hence, in our own devotional life, we need to learn to cry for Krishna's mercy, and hence, Bhakti Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Bhakti Yoga Dana, Bhakti A, Krishna Nama Smarana Krandana. The second realization is about the qualification of us to receive Mahaprabhu's benediction is not just crying. It is also about understanding that we are disqualified, and our only qualification to receive Mahaprabhu's mercy is our disqualification. Hence, our cry should just be not shedding tears, but is about consciously, repentantly, a yearning for mercy that will attract Mahaprabhu within ourselves. The third point is about Mahaprabhu's external reasons to appear. Number 1, distribute very rare mood of love of Godhead. Number 2, fulfill his promise in Bhagavad Gita. And number 3 is to satisfy Advaita Acharya for the prayers that he did. The fourth realization is about Mahaprabhu's three confidential reasons, which is to relish the position of Srimati Radharani, understand the transcendental mellow of himself, and to enjoy the bliss tasted by Srimati Radharani. The fifth realization is about the three unique aspects of Mahaprabhu's appearance. Is he is Adbhuta Karunya, amazingly merciful. He is Adbhuta Vadanya, he is amazingly magnanimous. He is Adbhuta Audarya, he is amazingly munificent. And the last realization is about some set of three prayers which we can offer to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to make us much, much more qualified and eventually offer useful services to his preaching movement. So those three prayers are, please help us in not committing any criticism or Vaishnava aparat. And number two, we commit and convince and take a sankalpa that we will preach to ourselves about the holy name and chant our prescribed number of rounds sincerely and attentively. And with that in mind, we will contribute to spreading of the holy name and be part of Mahaprabhu's mission to be a solution and not just be a problem. Hare Krishna, Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. If there are any questions or comments, we can discuss.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, Dandavat Pranam Sangha, Srila Prabhupada. Prabhuji very beautifully presented class. Prabhu, it was very comprehensive and wonderful for this important verse. It was so well given, Prabhu. Thank you so much. I really liked the first part where you were talking about the three devotees crying, which led to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance. That was very wonderful. And also about how chanting is actually, as we chant, if you're getting any service, then it's a recognition for the chanting that we are doing. I thought that was a very nice and very profound statement. Thank you so much, Prabhu, for the very wonderful class as usual. Thank you for your association. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Babuji. Dhanvat Pranam. Thank you so much. As Mataji said, that the class was very instructive and very Nectarian. So, Prabhuji, I have one question. That as you described, our disqualification is our qualification to get the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Prabhuji, like only thinking in the mind that we are disqualified, like doesn't work. So we should have that consciousness. So like we feel like we are disqualified, but at the same time, window pop-up came in our mind, oh, at least we are chanting, we are reading, we are giving some time, at least 2 hours, 3 hours, so we can get the mercy of Krishna. So how to think, like how to develop that consciousness, that how that consciousness will come that we are actually disqualified, we are not even chanting so nicely, attentively. So
one devotee very nicely taught a formula for that. So, I think I have shared that before. Our biggest problem is, so we are all told in the Bhagavatam class that each and every one of us should look ourselves in the mirror and see where do we stand. We have understood that instruction slightly differently. We have the mirror, but instead of putting the mirror facing upon ourselves to see ourselves, we are showing to everybody how they are and trying to see how others are bad. This is a primary weakness that each of us have. In a sense, the statement that Mahaprabhu mentioned, very simple two-liner statements, Anindaka hoy jay sakrit Krishna bhaje. Anindaka means ninda, criticism, fault finding, judgmental. These are all some bi-natural characteristics because of which we suffer. So the point I want to say is, the formula that Prabhu taught is, let us learn to be pessimistic on ourselves and optimistic on others. This means that let us learn to make sure that we appreciate, we glorify, we see good things in others and try to find out what we can improve within ourselves. It is very, very difficult for us to do this. But somehow somebody has learnt the art of doing it. It is impossible for them to fall down. Because one of the reasons for a person to fall down is that he tries to look how bad the other person is and how good we are. I gave this example before. If you see, in Agasura pastime, and many other places this similar thing is there, there are many, many verses, maybe 5, 10, 15, 20 verses, Sukadeva Goswami is glorifying about Agasura's gigantic body. So when I read these verses, I said, what are we supposed to, you know, what class we have to give? But after a few verses you see, Sukadeva Goswami has explained, such a gigantic animal, or a, you know, or a snake, Agasura, was killed by Krishna in no moment. So technically speaking, Sukadeva Goswami was doing a build-up, was trying to appreciate, glorify the Supreme Lord by defining how powerful Agasura was from our calculation and how easily Krishna won over. The same thing he did it for explaining about Hiranyakashipu and Narsingadev. There are many pastimes, I think, let's not go there. The point I am trying to say is, it is very difficult for us on our own to be considering ourselves disqualified. So the easiest way to know that we are actually disqualified is to go and appreciate and see good qualities of others. That's when we'll know where do we stand. If we only see, oh, you know what, my chanting is happening nicely. This exactly happened in Vritrasura pastime. If you see the first chapter, Indra, what he thought, I did my Mangalarti, I did my chanting, I did my Bhagavatam class, I did my service, now it is my time for relaxation. He sat and started looking at the dance of all the Apsaras. And that's when Brihaspati walked in. He said, I did my quota of devotional service today, so I am now fully allowed for enjoyment. So he was not becoming conscious. And that disrespect to Brihaspati led to one downfall after another downfall after another downfall. Finally, he has to be taught a lesson through Vritrasura's pastime. It's a very interesting, you know, episode. You all can read sometime. But the point is that we need to make sure that we don't look at what we are qualified or unqualified. We look at how others are so wonderful. The more we appreciate, the more we definitely perform. I'll tell a last point. In this material world, especially in the outside world, everybody proves their greatness by demonstrating how the other person is not great. 9 out of 10 instances, a person will prove how great he is by showing the other person down. And in Krishna consciousness, we should show how we are down by looking at others' greatness. If we do not know to look at others' greatness, that is the first bimari, first disease that we need to handle of ourselves. Because if we can't even see others good, how do we even see Krishna? How do we even see Krishna's glories? So hence, the important agenda is to somehow or other learn to see others good, then actually our disqualification will be very clearly revealed. Srila Prabhupada, one devotee wrote a letter to Srila Prabhupada. And finally he wrote, your most humble servant. Srila Prabhupada responded saying that you want to be most even in being humble. So it's a very subtle point, but it means a lot for us to practice in Krishna consciousness. Hence, to understand your disqualification, turn around and start appreciating. You'll naturally realize how low we are. If you don't start appreciating, don't start looking at others' good qualities, we'll always think how great we are and we'll go on patting on our back. Am I making sense?
Yes, Prabhupada, yes. Thank you so much, Prabhupada. So many nice points you explained. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol. Hare Krishna. Any other questions or comments?
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Thank you for a really wonderful class. My question is, I guess, asking you to repeat your realization about magnanimity, munificence, and I think mercy. And the reason why I'm asking you to repeat is because I'm kind of blending them a bit, because all three of those simply sound like his simply seem to refer to Chaitanya's supreme compassionate nature, you know, like magnanimity. Yeah, I mean, magnanimity sounds like very generous, I mean, extremely beyond reason, you know, kind of generosity. And
yeah, so
I think mercy,
it's like this. I'm sorry. The point is, by mercy, the Lord is delivering, relieving us from a trouble. By magnanimity, that relieving mercy, he is not restricting, he is profusely giving.
Uh-huh.
And by his munificency, he is making sure, I'm sorry, by his munificency, he is trying to give as generous as possible. And by his magnanimity, he is not seeing any qualification. Oh, you know what? You did this in the past. You are a sinner. You are a, you know, so-and-so. I will be restricting my mercy to only, I will give profuse. I will save this problem only for selected people. He didn't say that. He is saying my mercy is for everybody, unlimited. And that's what is about munificence and magnanimity. Mercy is the mercy.
Okay, so wait. So let me see if I got this. So the mercy aspect refers to the fact that he's relieving us of our suffering.
Yes.
By this path. And then the magnanimity is referring to, is that the one that's looking at the profuseness without?
No. Magnanimity aspect of it is referring about he is not seeing any qualification. Children, adult, boy, girl, you know, woman,
uh-huh.
Married, unmarried, diseased, undiseased, sinners, whoever it is. Magnanimous to everybody.
Indiscriminately, he's giving.
Indiscriminately, yes.
Yeah. And then munificence means profusely.
Generosity, yes.
Uh-huh.
And this combination has never existed in the past and will never happen. And that's Mahaprabhu.
Okay. All right. Wonderful.
Okay.
Wonderful.
Thank you
so much.
Okay. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Any other questions or comments? Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Thank you all so much for joining.